Hi guys, welcome back to Prosperity Channel TV. Thank you very much for always having you here. May God bless you all. While the 2023 general election draws near, Daniel Bwala, a spokesperson for Atiku Abubakar presidential campaign on Saturday, warned Peter Obi that the thin line between his speaking charges in his U.S. tours and fellowshipping with the Federal Bureau of Investigation, FBI, is not far. Gist makes media reports that Bwala's caution comes as Nigerians in the U.S. host Obi, the Labour Party flag bearer for the 2023 presidential election in 5 U.S. states. The presidential hopeful is expected to address town hall meetings and grant interviews in major cities of the leading democracy in the world. A filler has been doing the rounds on social media showing that Obi's town hall meeting with diasporan Nigerians in Atlanta, US, on Friday night has been monetized. This has elicited criticisms from his antagonist. Obi has in the recent past been in some Western nations where he addressed Nigerians and friends of the country in part to capacity halls. Earlier, Obi had met with some Nigerians in Germany, Italy, and Canada over his presidential ambition. He also visited the Vatican City in Rome, where he attended the ceremony where a Nigerian bishop, Peter Okpaleke of Ekulobia Diocese, was elevated to a cardinal in the Catholic Church. If Nigerian Labour Party have the ears and attention of Peter Obi, please ask him to immediately desist from the current speaking charges in his U.S. tours. The thin line between it and fellowshipping with FBI is not far, Bwala wrote in his known Twitter handle. So guys, what's your take on signing this? Gist made media reports that Bwala's caution Peter Obi over FBI arrest in US. While the 2023 general elections draws near, Daniel Bwala, a spokesperson for the Atiku Abubakar presidential campaign on Saturday, warned Peter Obi that the thin line between his speaking charges in his US tours and fellowshipping with the Federal Bureau of Investigation, FBI, is not far. Gist makes media report that Bwala's caution comes as Nigerians in the U.S. host Obi, the Labour Party flag bearer, for 2023 presidential election in 5 U.S. states. The presidential hopeful is expected to address town hall meetings and grant interviews in major cities of the leading democracy in the world. A filler has been doing the rounds on social media, showing that Obi's town hall meeting with diasporan Nigerians in Atlanta, US, on Friday night has been monetized. This has elicited criticisms from the antagonist. Obi has, in the recent past, been in some Western nations where he addressed Nigerians and friends of the country in packed to capacity halls. Earlier, Obi had met with some Nigerians in Germany, Italy, and Canada over the presidential ambition. He also visited the Vatican City in Rome, where he attended the ceremony where a Nigerian bishop, Peter Okpaleke of Ekulobia Diocese, was elevated to a cardinal in Catholic Church. If Labour Party have the ears and attention of Peter Obi, please ask him to immediately desist from the current speaking charges in his U.S. tours. The thin line between it and fellowshipping with FBI is not far, Bawala wrote in his Twitter handle. I beg, make una leave Peter Obi alone. Make una leave Peter Obi alone. I never see this kind thing. Make una leave Peter Obi alone. Mona, tell us why una candidate go win the next election. Enough of this. Peter Obi that. Peter Obi do this. Peter Obi not do this. Waiting now. Now let Peter Obi date this game. If you people see Peter Obi as a threat, make una step down for him. Then support him. Support him. The other day, Abubakar Malami also said that Nigerian government is going to prosecute those in abroad who are funding Peter Obi's campaign. He said that Peter Obi too will not go free from it. Now in Nigeria, don't they ask him, say, what of those people when do primary election, the dollars, within the Nigerian government fee do? In which law, in which constitution they say people when they're abroad, you know, they send money come? You don't reach Peter Obi time because then they see Peter Obi as a threat to them. They don't they talk one thing or the other. Well, anything when God get hand put, nobody go fit stop him. If God really wants Peter Obi to be the next president of Nigeria, all these ones when they talk in August structure, this and this, and this latest one now when they trained, say when they give him money from abroad and all that, it cannot stop him. Because when God raises his hand, no one stops the hands of God. That is one sweet thing about God. Well, my people, now don't hear the matter. Make a drop out for you. What's your take? Kindly share your thoughts below the comment section. Please do not forget to subscribe to this channel if you have not. Thank you very much. Bye for now.